at me.
Look at me.
On a personal level, I had been trained classically, and so I was into the Shakespeare hero. I had come off of, before Star Trek, I'd come off of the greatest human hero of all, I think. Alexander the Great had conquered the known world.
If I'm to be the woman of a Caesar, can't I know what you're up to?
He was young and apparently beautiful, and he rode his horses, and he had, you know, he had all the components of what we think of being heroic.
And before I put you in the brig, there's a little something I owe you.
And I had played him, and then my next big gig was Star Trek, so I think I brought some of Alexander the Great to Captain Kirk.
A canal, and with it, we'll bring the water from the lake right to the lodge. And we can expand the system, see? And irrigate the fields, and double the food supply.
You know, I was just noticing your Vulcan itic, Mr. Spock. Is it a reminder that as a Vulcan, you can mind link with the Medusans far better than I could?
Well, I doubt that Mr. Spock would don the most revered of all Vulcan symbols merely to annoy you.
And remember, we were dealing with things that were very important to him. It was infinite diversity from infinite combinations. And Gene always felt that that would solve all of the problems of the world. And one day, it still may be.
I understand, Mr. Spock. The glory of creation is in its infinite diversity.
And the ways our differences combine to create meaning.
It was at a time in the 60s where the civil rights movement, people were fighting to be recognized with dignity, just to sit in a restaurant to eat, the right to sit in a restaurant, to the right to walk into a hotel and have your reservation honored, the right to simply have an opportunity like anyone else born free in this country.
I mean, nobody else was trying this, yet you see under one roof, you know, a Scotsman.
I'd have expected sanity from the ship's surgeon, at least. President Lincoln, indeed.
An Asian. An African-American woman who had a very important job.
Lieutenant Uhura, take over navigation.
Yes, Captain.
And, you know, a playboy cowboy guy from Iowa, a funny-looking alien with pointy ears and a Mo Howard hairdo. You had the wildest combination of people, and nobody commented upon it within the context of that show. This was the future as they saw it was going to be, and the color of our skin, how we look, wasn't going to matter 300 years hence.
Where you come from? Are there a lot of people without the power and my size?
Alexander, where I come from, size, shape, or color makes no difference.